Hey Kansas City Chiefs fans, it's BJ Kissel again with another video for the Arrowhead Pride YouTube channel. This is the 7th video in this series, and if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, I would recommend doing that because as a subscriber, you're going to get a notice every time we post a new video, and as we get closer to the season and even into the season, we're going to be posting more and more videos, and that way you won't miss anything. So, last week we talked about the Chiefs' first round draft pick in Dontari Poe, the defensive tackle from Memphis, and we even took a look at a few of his clips from last season, and we got to see that athletic ability that so many people have talked about. Well, this week we're going to talk about another player the Chiefs drafted on the defensive side of the ball in Alabama safety Dequan Menzie with our 5th round pick. I think most Chiefs fans knew that there were two areas that the Chiefs would address at some point in the draft, and that being offensive line depth and the safety depth. Well, the Chiefs addressed the offensive line depth in the 2nd and 3rd round with Jeff Allen and Donald Stevenson, and I don't know about you guys, but I got pretty nervous the later it got into the draft and we hadn't yet addressed the safety position. And I even threw out on Twitter before we ended up drafting Menzie that for the love of God, please let us draft a safety. And so I was excited when we took Menzie for a couple of different reasons. One being I thought he was a good player, and second of all, for whatever reason, I just personally think guys coming from an Alabama defense, especially secondary players, I just think they might be able to pick up the game a little bit quicker at the pro level because Alabama runs such an intricate defense playing for Nick Saban there. And, you know, he played the star role is what they called it at Alabama, which is the same thing that Javier Arenas had played. And we're going to take a look at 4 different plays from Menzie last season and show a little bit of that versatility. It's not an in-depth breakdown as much as it is showing that they moved him around. They did a lot of different things with him. And as he's projected to be a cornerback slash safety, I think that he's got a role with the Chiefs defense. So this is what we're first going to show here is a still of the Chiefs defense, the Chiefs subset defense last season. And a lot of the talk heading into the draft was about John McGraw and trying to upgrade, you know, the role that he played in our subset defense. So we talked about McGraw almost lining up as a linebacker. And here's a still of that specific defense that we're talking about. We see McGraw here in the middle lined up in the box. You've got Alan Bailey and Wallace Gilberry there as the 2 down defensive tackles. And you've got Justin Houston and Tamba Ali as the 2 outside linebackers up on the line of scrimmage. You've got Javier Arenas in the slot and then Carr and Flowers on the outside and then DJ running in the middle. And you've got 2 deep safeties that we can't see. But, you know, one of the things that may have gotten lost in talking about upgrading that specific position is the fact that we have a Pro Bowl safety that was on IR last year that could probably play up in the box and do pretty well with it in Eric Berry. So it's not to say that Menzie might not be the replacement for John McGraw in this specific defense, but we've also got Eric Berry and his prowess against the run up near the line of scrimmage as a playmaking safety might be a better spot for him. But that's not to say Menzie might not be there, but it would be a good role for Berry as well. And here's another still when we played the San Diego Chargers where we have John McGraw lined up basically as a middle linebacker right in the middle of the defense. So obviously there's a few different ways that Menzie could be used in our subset defenses coming as a cornerback or a safety. We're going to show 4 plays when he was playing for Alabama of him doing some different things and talk about how that might translate to the Chiefs subset defense. So this first play we're going to look at with Menzie is him being physical up against the run. You're going to see him here at the bottom of the screen lock up with his guy and drive him backwards. One of the things, if you rewatch the play again, one of the things you're going to notice is as soon as the running back gets the ball and looks up, he's going to see Menzie driving his guy backwards, which cuts the angle to bouncing the play to the outside off. Menzie obviously didn't get credit for the tackle, but I think he did his job in kind of funneling the play inside, and I definitely think he cut off the outside route for the running back and hence, you know, changed the outcome of the play, which was a good thing. And as a guy who's projected to be a cornerback slash safety, I think the willingness to be physical against the run is something that he's going to use and something that is going to be to his benefit playing in the subset defense, because one of the things that Scott Pioli talked about with Dontari Poe and would translate to the subset defense as a whole is that we need to get better against the run in that particular defense. And that also includes the defensive backs being physical and being able to do things just like Dequan Menzie did on this play. This next play we're going to show is him basically blitzing from the slot corner position that we see Javier Arenas playing a lot. You're going to see him lined up on the slot receiver, and right before the ball snap, you're going to see him kind of coming inside and blitzing. You see the safety going over to play man against the guy that he was head up on, and then you're going to see the athletic ability of him to chase the guy down and make the play. So just another example of how they moved him around, blitzed him. In the next play, we're going to show him playing a little zone coverage and reading and reacting to what the quarterback's doing. So here on this next play, you're going to see him sitting down here in the corner about maybe a yard or two off tackles, 6 or 7 yards off the line of scrimmage. And you're going to see him just easily sit back in the zone. You're going to see the guy that he was head up on kind of run around. You can see that he was in zone, not playing man coverage. You're going to see him read and react to the quarterback. Obviously, it's still a, you know, 5 yard completion, but as soon as the ball is caught, Menzie's right there to make a play on it. So just another versatile example of, you know, things that Menzie can do out there on the field. And this last play we're going to show is him blitzing and getting to the quarterback. Doesn't make the sack, but you're going to see him there at the top of the screen come after. Doesn't get the sack, but obviously disrupts the play. And again, it's not an in-depth breakdown, but it does show how they moved him around, how they did some different things with him. And if they're willing to do that with him at Alabama and move him around, obviously, you know, it's something that he could do for the Chiefs defense. And as a cornerback safety guy and helping, you know, provide some more depth for the both those positions for us, I think it's going to help us moving forward. So while, you know, there's not a defined position, as we talked about, maybe Eric Berry being able to be the one to take over for John McGraw, there's still a role for Dequan Menzie to play for the Chiefs defense next season. And, you know, one of those bold predictions, I'm not quite prepared to make it yet, but one of those bold predictions, if Menzie can go out there and play special teams, is of all the guys the Chiefs drafted this year, Dequan Menzie could get more snaps next year than anybody else. Because if he can find a role in our subset defense and all the special teams that I think he'll be able to go out there and play, he and Dontari Poe hopefully will battle it out for most plays, you know, on the Chiefs, you know, for the Chiefs as rookies. So here's a look at Dequan Menzie, and hopefully he makes a big impact for the Chiefs defense and helps take us to that next level. For the new Arrowhead Pride YouTube channel, I'm BJ Kissel.